All right, so here's the deal. I have been throwing swim baits for quite a while, about a decade. And I have thrown everything from HUDs, caught some giants on HUDs, S wavers, DRTs here lately, Depths. Depths has been like my all-time favorite glide bait forever. A couple days ago, I got to throw this. You can read the box. It says Hinkle. I custom painted this one in the shop. We custom paint, by the way. Dustin dials them in. We custom painted that. And that's right. It looks like a rainbow trout. It's a huge bait. I think it's an 11-inch bait. It weighs about, I don't know if I had to guess, 10 ounces, 9 or 10 ounces. It is a behemoth of a bait. This is the Hinkle Trout. I have never, ever seen fish react to a lure like I have this thing my first day throwing it. So I'm going to roll some footage real quick. Back-to-back cast. Check this out.
If you want to throw a wacky rig, if you just want to catch fish, bro, freaking catch fish. I went fishing with, oh my gosh, here's a big one. He's gonna hit it. Got him.
Oh, he put it in his mouth.
He's gonna hit it. Got him. Oh, he put it in his mouth.
I think
dude, there's a freaking, there's a big one. No. He freaking hit it. Yep. Remember, did I go over you or under you?
Think.
Remember, this bait's 11 inches and oh God, he just hit it too.
Remember, this bait's 11 inches and oh God, he just hit it too.
Okay, so. Right, I literally figurated one right next to the boat. My very next cast, I say there's one cruising. I throw up there, glide it twice, and one just throttles it. This is a big bait, right? So it's 11 inches. I've got 6 inches of space between those two treble hooks. I've got another 4 inches off the back, and another couple inches up here in the front. It's gonna happen where fish just miss this bait or they don't get hooked, and that's just part of big swim bait fishing. But I wanna talk about what I saw immediately when throwing this bait. The first follower I had, you know, a lot of guys wonder like, hey, how do I turn those followers into biters? And it's a lot of reading their body language. When I see their fins going real fast and they're making those sharp, tight cuts behind that lure, what they're doing is they're trying to size it up and figure out how they can turn around and headshot that bait a lot of times. I had 4 followers in my first about 20 minutes, and every single fish tried to figure out how to square this bait up. Every single one had what I call, they're hot. They're getting hot. They're hot on it. Every single one had hot body language. The 2 fish that came out first, they were hot on it. They got too close to the boat. The sun hit me. I was in kind of a brighter shirt, and as soon as the sun hit me and they saw me, they kind of darted away. But you know, it was a 4, another one about 5, and then back-to-back 5s that hit this thing. But the body language I saw, their fins were going, they were doing those sharp, tight cuts. And the big thing with this bait is it's big. It moves a lot of water. So naturally, when I'm thinking about throwing a giant swim bait like this, this is the biggest swim bait in my arsenal. I know it's not the biggest swim bait in Dustin's arsenal, but when I think about throwing this, I think about, man, it has freakish draw power. Like a Depths 250 has unreal draw power. This thing has ridiculous draw power. And what I've seen just out of one day, this thing is going to absolutely smash giants the next year for me. And I'm really, really excited. I'm gonna continue to dial it in. I can't get those super tight cuts and turns because it is such a big bait. It has such a big wide glide. I can't, you know, it does have a little bit of play to do those tight turns to really trigger those bites. But like I said, there is so much body language that I've seen out of those fish in my first day of throwing it. This bait is going to be one of, if not my favorite glide bait. So the allure with this bait, you know, I've seen footage from like Mike Gilbert with Working Class Zero. I've seen some stuff from my buddy Oliver Nye, you know, down in Texas, and the bait catches giant bass. There is no question about it. A customer of mine this year, actually on a guide trip, was like, man, I bought this Hinkle. He had it colored in perch, which I didn't necessarily like, but he moved some giant bass with it. But I know that this bait is a proven bass catcher, and I know it's really proven, really, in Texas, Arizona, Southern California, and I don't really know. I have a couple buddies locally in Western North Carolina, North Georgia, that have thrown them, some with some decent success, but honestly, not a whole lot of success. And honestly, there's not a lot of these floating around. So for me, I'm thinking about, it's unique in the fact that it's rare, it's hard to get your hands on them, it's huge, so it has giant draw power, but there hasn't been a lot of fishing pressure with this exact bait. So I think the sky's the limit. I'm gonna incorporate this into my arsenal in a big way. And I mean, it's gonna get some serious tooth rash and hook rash. I can't wait maybe just a couple weeks just to see where we're at with it. And it's already got some tooth marks from the fish the other day that just absolutely slammed. And I'm really excited. We have them in the store. Listen, they are extremely rare baits. eBay them. Look up Hinkle Trout. They're going for $650. We have them in the shop for $350, almost 50% off of what they go for on the open market. Custom painted, dialed in, it's hot. So anyways, call us 828-354-0250, order them, book a trip with us, everything at the shop. Hinkle Trout's a beast. I'm in love.